And you always hear about the word culture when describing franchises in sports these days. But how important is that really?
It's everything, Blake. Without a strong culture, no franchise will ever truly find long-term success. You want to foster an environment that players are proud to be a part of. And WNBA teams do a great job of that.
They do, Brian, and it's great to see. To me, culture comes down to what your organization stands for. And when they stand for the right things, the result is always a more unified franchise. With that 6'8 frame, Kempe moves well, too, can close out on shooters.
Jesse Gray for three. Elizabeth Williams with the rebound. Outside, Williams. Pass to Sims. And she wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron.
She draws so much attention. Williams can find other threes. He buckets. He did.
Trails the three-pointers.
Fired that bounce pass a little beautifully.
Here's Carter. Outside, Williams. Back to Carter. To the inside. And Williams gets it to go.
What vision from Carter, able to survey the court and find the open player.
Kelsey Gray for three. And it's Atlanta with the rebound. Pass break, here come the dream. Carter, that's good.
And this is the start they wanted. Come out and put some points up early, hitting 3 of 4.
Kelsey Gray for three. Carter with the rebound. Here's the break. All sorts of time. They grab their own miss. Courtney Williams for three. Connects from three-point range.
You know, there are certain players who shoot much better off a pass. Williams is one of them. Allows her to set her feet. Well, despite being the 8th overall pick back in the 2016 WNBA draft, Courtney Williams was actually traded during her rookie year. Williams played just 6 games with the Mercury before she was sent to play for the Connecticut Sun. But really, it wasn't the worst thing for her career. She found a role with Connecticut and made the finals with them in 2019.
See Gray for three. And the Aces, another three.
This is who Gray is. A terrific shooter who seeks payback when he drained one on her squad.
Pass to Sims. Back to Hawkins. A beautiful reverse layup.
Way to crash the offensive glass there. And once she gets her hands on it, you know it's going back up in it.
The three. And that's good. Jackie Young for three. And Brian, with Courtney Williams getting traded in her first WNBA season, how do you think that helped her grow as an overall player?
I'm sure it wasn't easy for her, Blake, but at least she learned the business side of basketball early. Some players don't get traded until later in their careers, and then they just don't really know how to handle it. But I'm proud of the way Williams took it in stride and refused to let it stop her career ascension.
The new group getting ready for the dream. Pass to Sims. Parker with the ball. And here is Hayes. 6 on the shot clock. Side Parker. Another shot. Yep, that goes.
4 of their last 5 makes came off a high-quality shot inside.
And that's right out of the textbook. They are having their way down low right now.
Now here's Hamby. Another 3 for Las Vegas.
Both great points off the 3-pointers, and the team looks shell-shocked.
And now that they're rolling from out there, you've got to get it in their jersey and try to deny those shots.
Especially how well people shoot.
This one for three. Here's Bambe. Got it. Good job in the low post.
Yeah, they've got themselves in front right now with some outstanding shooting right off the bat. You like to see that aggression early on.
It's been just an absolute clinic at that end of the floor. They're filling it up.
Tries again. And Parker with the layup.
They're finding lanes to the hoop every time down. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior,
or at least some fight. Last five makes, all five from long range.
And the defense hasn't pressed up to deny it. They're hanging back, and they're getting picked apart.
Pressure the ball, pressure the man, pressure something.
Atlanta. They trail by 7. 2 points. That one goes in.
Makes a good team a great team. It's Hayes' intensity that gets her whole team going.
Three-pointer, Kelsey Plum. Another three for Las Vegas.
Three-pointers are killing them, and they haven't been able to respond at the other end.
But the way to turn that around is defensively, you know, by stopping their outside shot, not by getting into a shootout.
Parker, good.
Fundamental hoops from Odyssey Sims, making sure to get it to the uncovered teammate.
Here's Young. And that one's good.
Either team conditionally off. I don't know how long they can keep this up.
Offensively, at least. Neither team's done jack on D yet.
Let's follow me.
We've seen some great shots in the first quarter. No shortage of offense. The Aces on top, leading by 8. And quarter two will get underway just after this short break. Now the second quarter getting ready to start up. And guys, what's your take on the Aces so far?
Scoring has come in threes for the most part so far.
Yeah, and every time down the floor, it seems like they're hitting a triple.
Aces leading. Plum with it. Guarded now by Hayes. Plum can't hit.
Yeah, just like me. I can't believe that layup didn't fall. I don't think she can either.
Inside. Here's Hayes. And she uses the glass on the layup.
Another bucket in the paint. That's just something they have not been able to stop today. And if they want to win this game, they got to figure out how to stop it.
You know, Brian, time to switch things up on the team. What they've got going on right now is not getting it done.
To the paint. Here's Billings. That drops. And it comes off an assist from Tiffany Hayes.
They're beginning to just fall apart defensively, especially on the interior.
Yeah, they're crumbling like a cookie right now. And that's 4 straight field goals they've allowed from within touching distance of the rim.
Drains the three-pointer.
A confidence builder for sure. When Odyssey Sims is knocking down the triple, it unleashes the rest of her offense.
Now a timeout called by Las Vegas. Well, we've seen it in other leagues, including the NBA. Are we about to see the super team era in the WNBA?
With the movement during the offseason prior to the 2020 season, we really saw the best teams in the league add stars. The biggest move had to be the trade involving all-star guard Skylar Diggins-Smith, but there were also some other moves involving big-time players.
Multiple-time all-WNBA selection, Angel McCautry has found a new home, and Joanna Bonner has a move as well. While the super teams load up, on the other side, we've seen a clear youth movement other places in the league.
And that one's good. Hawkins.
Fantastic pass. She made that a very easy bucket with the setup.
Kelsey Gray for 3. Another 3 for Las Vegas.
They're going back to the 3-point shot over and over again.
They might have found the Achilles heel of this defense. That was their 9th straight point from beyond the arc.
Outside Carter. For Gray. That one a tad offline to the right, but it drops in for him.
You watch Carter play, you see a player who just knows how to score no matter where she is on the floor.
Well, guys, for her size, Courtney Williams is an outstanding rebounder. She's listed at 5'8", but she seems to play a lot bigger than that. I'm just so impressed with her grit and toughness on the boards.
Here's Carter. And again, Atlanta with the triple.
Just imagine trying to guard Kennedy Carter with her speed, and then you see her use the pull-up. You just gotta throw up your hands defensively.
And Tim, what are the biggest advantages to having a relentless rebounder like Williams on your team?
It starts with inspiration, Blake, because when you see your guard, rebounding the way Williams does, it pushes everyone else to match her intensity. And rebounding has always been a team effort, so her coaches have to appreciate her willingness to do the dirty work.
And the Aces with possession. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Goes up at the stripe, and it's in after a nice bounce off the right iron.
Such a skilled shooter. I'd say the mid-range J has been in Williams' arsenal for a while.
Stolen by Chelsea Gray. Williams can't get it to go. Atlanta trailing here. Outside Carter. Yes, and it's Courtney Williams with the assist that time.
Yeah, Carter almost makes this look effortless. Plants her feet, drills it.
Chelsea Gray for 3. And Hawkins pulls it down. And these guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice assists.
When everybody's involved offensively, it's in a way helping you defensively too.
That is some dime dropping. Exquisite assist.
Second quarter. And it's Tiffany Ames with the block. And she recovers it.
Yeah, she's been off her game this quarter. Just hasn't been able to get a whole lot to go down.
She nails it, and we're tied up.
As underrated as they come, Hayes is a star who doesn't command the attention that her play deserves.
And that one's good. Great.
Yeah, you know how a lot of people talk about flipping the switch? Well, her switch has definitely been flipped to on in this quarter, guys. I mean, just dominant scoring. You simply cannot say enough about the quarter she's having. I mean, every one of her attempts has gone down.
And it's Gray missing.
Yeah, the great shooters, they know when they've got enough opening to go for the 3. I didn't think it was a bad choice then.
Yeah, not very good defensive coverage that time, but you got lucky.
And out of bounds, the Aces will take it. So both teams changing it up here. Here's Las Vegas. Pass to Hamby. Three-pointer. The three-pointer is on target.
And those points all start with Gray. The tremendous feat, unselfishness of the All-Star.
It's stolen by Hamby. Let's it go from deep. It's rebounded by Atlanta. Side of the rim, and it swirls in.
They've had assists now on their last 3 baskets.
Everybody always thinks it's passing that gets you assists, but also their movement off the ball, it's created those opportunities.
Now Carter. The 3 ball. And released it in time, but it's off the mark. And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of play. Aces ahead, leading by 4. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back out there for the start of the third quarter after the break.
Dropping for her. Absolute dead-eye shooting in that first half.
Yeah, I'll say. this could not have been a more productive day for her from long range.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. From outside the arc, and the Aces another three. Can they make some sort of defensive adjustment? Because guess what? She is killing them from three-point range.
And even when they have closed out on her, she's still knocking them down. I mean, this is just an unbelievable performance we're seeing right now. Way to work the ball in close to the hoop.
The reality for a majority of WNBA players is the need to play overseas in addition to the U.S. What challenges do these players face?
Well, the first thing, Blake, is just your physical health. I mean, lots of players go straight from the overseas season right into the WNBA regular season. You know how grueling this season can be. Avoiding injuries is always the first goal, but it is draining to constantly be playing at the highest level.
Yeah, and it's just draining from a mental standpoint as well. You know, for the American players, you spend most of the year away from your family and friends, and a lot of times in countries where you might not be used to their culture or language.
And Atlanta has possession. It's a 10-point game. And the foul on Williams. That's her first foul.
Posting up and attacking the hoop. Unreal skills for a guard. 4-5 to start the half, coming out strong.
Once Chelsea Gray entered the starting lineup for the Sparks in 2017, she was rock solid in LA. From 2017 to 2019, Gray started all 102 regular season games. Just so reliable at the point guard position.
And it's the Aces with the ball. They lead by 11, the largest margin of the game. And that's good. Jackie Young for three.
Great outside shooting is really fueling this run.
And the D's just getting bombarded. They haven't been able to slow them down.
And Gray's consistency is so key for what has been a great stretch of basketball for arguably the league's premier franchise in the Sparks.
Well, Gray was top five in the WNBA minutes per game over that 2017 to 2019 time frame. And really, you don't just count on her to play in the games, but also play well. Gray's been top five in total assists those 3 years.
That's also good, so she hits a boat.
Well, Hawkins won her first WNBA championship in 2019. And with her skill set, I'd be surprised if she doesn't win at least one more.
Raquana Williams for three. Las Vegas.
Well, they're getting their points now almost exclusively from three-point range. For the last 5 makes from beyond the arc.
And the defense practically giving them those shots.
And they'll take them.
She had her head on a swivel and was able to still pick up the pass and get the assist.
Kelsey Plum from outside. Bangs home the trifecta.
They've given up so many threes today.
Their defensive rotations on the perimeter have been abysmal.
Pass to Hawkins. Fires for three. It doesn't go for it. So Las Vegas will take it the other way. Here's Park. The three-pointer off the mark. And here we go, the dream on the fast break. Up top, Hawkins. Wilson pulls it down. Not her best performance scoring the ball thus far. Out of bounds, it'll go to the dream. Both teams deciding to change it up. And now we're 3 minutes into this third quarter play.
Come on,
Tiffany Hayes for three. Score the bucket. She's made 5 so far. 5-7. And it's the Aces with the ball. At one point, they led by 16. Got that one up quick.
And had another three-pointer to their second.
Here's Wilson. Shot, no good. And the Dream going the other way now. And here we go, the Dream on the fast break. Kept alive by Atlanta. Parker. And the shot goes in.
Ferociously rips down boards. Parker has an extra gear she taps into when crashing the glass.
Launches a three, and that's good. Jackie Young for three.
These defenders better start closing down their shooters.
Yeah, it's too straight from long range. Atlanta calls timeout.
They've been committing a lot of turnovers, and I imagine that's exactly what they're talking about right now. They need to tighten it up.
Joining us, we'll see what happens in the fourth. Now here is Sims. She's covered by Hamby. Pass to Billings. Hayes. That's good again. And her seventh basket, 7 for 10 from the floor.
I'm such a fan of the pace and the rhythm that Hayes plays with. I mean, she can get herself going in no time.
She got her way to putting up a big three-point total.
Now here is Hayes. She's guarded by Plum. Outside Sims. Billings. Banked in off the glass.
Most seasons, Sims is in the top 10 among assist leaders, a true combo guard capable of scoring and dishing.
Mercy Gray for three. Another three for Las Vegas.
Awareness from Wilson. She knows that opponents lock in on her, so she's happy to dish and keep her teammates involved.
No coverage that time.
Her stroke has been dead on. Inside, outside, wherever, the shots are falling for her.
pulls up on the wing, and the Aces back on two more.
15, maybe 18 feet. This is about the extent of Wilson's range, a center who doesn't need to chuck up threes to be effective.
Pass to Parker. Here's Carter. Good D by Erica Hampe. And this could get even more out of hand if they continue to put up points.
What a performance it's been. Not sure what the D was doing there. She's not the player to give open looks to, but they got away with it that time.
Cheyenne Parker's got space. The shot goes down. Very quick possession right there.
Works hard moving without the ball. You know, Parker's a player whose value goes beyond the box score.
And the ball out of play. The three will have it.
Really careless turnover. That could have been the simplest of exchanges.
Both teams will make substitutions. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Outside Sims. Billings sinks the 15-footer. Atlanta has possession. They trail by 18. Carter. Yes. And it's Courtney Williams with the assist that time.
When Carter catches fire, she stays after it. This aggressive mindset is what allows her to pour the points off, dominate an offense.
Very close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Not a great habit to get into, letting her get that wide open.
Well, things are finally coming together for them. The deficit's still pretty big, but at least they're moving in the right direction.
Yeah, and facing that kind of deficit, they're going about it the right way. They're getting aggressive on defense, getting stops, and they're taking good care of the basketball at the other end. Yeah,
at least now they're playing good basketball.
Here's Williams. It's good from the top of the key.
Double team, triple team, zone defense, something. You gotta figure out a way to shut her down.
Deflected, and it's out of bounds. The Dream able to retain possession here.
That pass had a little bit too much heat on it for her to make a clean steal.
Yeah, that was going to be a tough catch for either of them. I mean, these are basketball players, not wide receivers.
A look at the clock, a little under 3.5 minutes gone in the fourth.
The great length of Wilson, it really aims her rejecting shots. Asia's normally top five in the league in shot blocks.
Elizabeth Williams is going to pick up the foul. That's her first foul. Gray outside. And a three off target. Outside Williams. The offensive rebound. And good that time.
Like she's on a pogo stick. Williams up for the board, down a moment, then up for the points. What energy!
First overall in 2018 by Las Vegas, Asia Wilson definitely lived up to the hype that year. She won Rookie of the Year, finished third in the league in scoring with 20 points per game. She was top 10 in blocks and rebounding, and on top of all of that, she was also named a WNBA All-Star. What a rookie year.
She's guarded by Williams. Back to Brown. And the layup's good off the glass.
Well, their offense is kicking the gear, but it's come just a little too late.
I think it may be, but at least they're finally showing some signs of life offensively, but too bad it's past the point where it'll do them much good.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't want to say that they're trying to run up the score, but they do keep adding up to that lead.
Well, if you won't say it, partner, I will. They're trying to run up the score here.
Thanks for saying that, Brian. That's some nice work on the offensive glass.
And they can burn some clock if they want.
And calm down, get a little breather here too.
Three-pointer. Rebounded by Parker. The Dream on offense. It's a 14-point game. And it's Hayes missing. G's covered by Brown. And the three ball is good.
The vision Gray has on the floor is exceptional. Spots an opening and picks up the assist. Excellent defense, a potent offensive effort, and they were pretty much dominant.
So that's going to do it for this one, folks.